Ashan, welcome to today's session. Today will be like our introductory session for BA ABAP training. So as part of this session, we will see what all the steps we are going to cover, and we'll also start with the fundamentals of ABAP. Okay. So first I will just go through the stuff which we are going to cover. It is predominantly we have discussed in the call, but just we'll have a overview what all things we will be covering, then we'll straight away start with the answer. Okay. And just to give introduction about myself, myself Venugopal Anman, I'm a senior SAP BA ABAP consultant. I started my career as ABAPer and then moved on to BW, and I was a quality lead for one of the project. I worked for companies like Infosys, then moved on to TechM, currently working for one of the Mexican largest IT organization. So coming to my hobbies, I do lot of research on current technology trends. I do technology talks in universities over here in India. And as a hobby, I started Android app development 6 years back, and currently we have published around 50 plus application in Google Play Store. These are couple of with respect to SAP. All are available for free, and these are having just interview reference and a certification material. Few what I can say, the collection of certification related stuff and interview questions. Then coming to, maybe you can just give a overview of yourself, and then we'll start off.
What happening is I always look.
Okay, as an introduction, we'll see the features of ABAP programs and ABAP editor, which is almost similar to Notepad, but there are some shortcuts we can just recap, and we'll also see a couple of simple programs which correlate our BW requirements, the day-to-day basis, whatever the scenario which we get, right? We'll take up those and we'll try to see the hands-on of those in the basics. And we'll also see what are the different types of data types which SAP ABAP supports. Operator, we have arithmetic operator and logical operators. And we have condition and break statement like if else statement, case statement, continue statement and exit statement. We won't go by topic by topic. We'll take a real time example, and in that we'll start discussing, because if we go by topic and topic, that is the way even academic people will follow. But for us as a professional, sir, that won't be the best approach. So we'll take real-time scenarios and start discussing on those. Okay. So as part of today's session, we'll cover that. And once we're done with that, we'll start with internal tables and work area, because deep understanding of this particular concept is very much required. Because if you see in SAP, each and every configuration, stream flow logic or anything, ultimately it will be stored in a database table as a data, correct? So in order to handle our business data or configuration data, we have to, during runtime, we have to pull the data from database table and store it in one of the runtime objects. Those are called internal tables. And SAP won't allow you to handle internal table content in a single shot. Okay. So SAP has given one more object called work area, in which you can handle content of internal tables record by record. Right. So we'll see different stuff over there, declaration, operation on internal table, different ways you can write a select statement over there, and what are the best practices and in which scenario you can go for which kind of select statement and all. Once we are done with that, we'll move on to modularization techniques in SAP ABAP. This modularization technique is nothing but making your code look simpler, or making your code like a future enhancement easier. Like instead of writing a code one below the other, we can create a blocks, and we can encapsulate the set of, say suppose all the data declaration, you can encapsulate inside a include, or else you can create a block where a particular process will happen. All of the statement which will pull data from database table will keep in a separate block. The main logic will keep it in a separate block. So any future enhancement is needed. Any user apart from you, if they come back and see the code, it should be understandable to them in a easier manner, and they should be able to do the maintenance easily. So we'll SAP has given couple of techniques. We'll discuss those. Those are include subroutines and function modules. Okay, we'll see all those things in detail. And function module, we'll take it up in detail because deep understanding of this particular function module is required for your some of BW requirement, like calling RFC from one system to other system. And also this foundation will help you in understanding generic extractor based on function module. So we'll start creating a simple function module from the scratch. Maybe it can accept two number as input and give someone product as output. We'll test that, and we'll see how to call the function module from independent SC38 program, or else anywhere where we can write a ABAP program. We have an option to do that. We'll see that, and then we'll increase the complexity, like pulling data from database table and giving as part of a function module output. And maybe it will accept, we can create a function module which will accept data as input, and it will give fiscal year, cal day, cal month, and maybe the last day of current month as output. So stuff like that. Then once we are done with that, we are thorough with our basics. Then we will move on to generic extractor based on function modules, where we will see a lot of scenarios, like how to pull the data from single table, multiple table, how to read value passed by the user, and how to use a cursor concept to pull data packet by packet. Okay. And these are the steps involved. We'll go in detail to create a generic extractor based on function module. We'll discuss the respective topic. And once we're done with that, we'll move on to enhancement of standard extractor using user exit and BADI approach. We have both approaches given by SAP. Recently, if you have heard, BADI works on OOPS concept, which is object-oriented programming concept. And BADI have a little bit, so we can say it has its own advantage compared to user exit approach. So we'll see what is the advantage and which is the best practices. So you can achieve the same result both using user exit and BADI, and both will take the same amount of time for the execution. But only thing is, for maintenance or if at all multiple people are working, so there won't be any locking issues and so that we can discuss. Once we're done with that, we are done with all the ECC related topics. Then we'll move on to BW. We'll see routines in BW transformations in detail, wherein we will discuss all kinds of different possible routines, like start routine, end routine, expert routine, feed level routine, what the best practice, how to do lookup, and which kind of select statement you can use, and what are the different types of internal table which SAP offers, and any given point of time, how can I increase the performance of my particular code by following the different types of internal tables or best practices which is offered by SAP. Then Bex part, I guess you are familiar, but if you need any particular example, like based on one value, we have to restrict value of the other. Say suppose we have a country and we have a state, two fields are there. Country, yes, based on country, say suppose if I choose India, it has to show in the F4 value of the other state, right? It has to show only state related to India. If I choose US, it has to show the state code related to US. Like that scenario, if at all you are thorough with that, fine. If not, these are kind of complex scenarios, like we'll see that.
Yes. And all these things we are going to do with the OOPS concept, right? Or how you are going to explain?
See, OOPS concept is one of the concepts because, right? See, it is combination of both actually. If you, whatever the example which we discussed, right, restriction of F4 value will be, you can implement only using BADI, okay? It is OOPS concept only. So we are going to implement custom implementation of the standard BADI. So we'll be writing a code in a method, so which is nothing but OOPS concept.
Okay, okay, yeah.
And wherever is required. And as I said earlier, we have a standard extractor enhancement using both user exit and BADI approach. We'll discuss both the approaches. There we will follow the normal structured programming, and whereas OOPS also required when we go with the enhancement of standard extractor using BADI. There is a BADI given by SAP, that is I guess RSAFI BADI, SAPI BADI, something is there. We will implement that, okay? And recently SAP has given one more BADI, which is in SAP 7.3 onwards, I believe, for customer exit variable value population, right? It has released one baddie. So instead of user exit approach, you can go with baddie approach also. Total three baddies are, yeah, you can say. If the demo system is okay, based on 7.3, I can take it up that also. Okay. And we have restriction of F4 values in case of big selection screen. We'll see that. And one more thing you requested, the planning means duplicating a record. We will go and hit a particular info provider, and based on that, we will create a duplicate record and save it in one more info provider or the same info provider for your planning.
Yes. Yeah.
And maybe we can also see routines in case of DTP and info package. It depends actually. If you are comfortable, we can skip that, or else we can have one session wherein we can see how to programmatically populate value for your DTP filter value or info package filter value.
Okay. Okay.
And you are comfortable with the debugging?
Yes. Okay. Yes. All right. I'm not with a very standard one, but the customization what we are going to make, I am able to debug it and I am able to do the changes.
Sure, great. Because debugging, we are not going to take as a somebody who is new to this field also. The general approach which I follow, right, I won't be taking debugging and best practices as a last session or a single session, because every day from the day one I will keep explaining the best practices and the debugging techniques, so that by the time we complete half of our training, the candidate should be in a position to handle its own all the debugging and best practices. So that's all about the training. So we'll start with the basics today. Okay. There is some issue with the ECC system, so I will start creating in BW. Then once the issue is resolved, I will go back to ECC. Okay. So I mean SC38 transaction code in the SAP system, it can be either BW or ECC, anything. So for that, let us see the features of HABAP editor. Okay, just quickly. So coming to features of HABAP program and HABAP editor, the syntax of HABAP is similar to COBOL. When they started this HABAP programming language in early 90s or late 80s, I can say, they referred the COBOL programming language and they started developing, and day by day they started adding more and more syntaxes or more and more functionality. Okay. And HABAP statement and keywords are case insensitive. It means if you write code in uppercase or lowercase, it doesn't matter to the compiler. Both are same for the compiler. Okay. And custom program must start with Y or Z. You are aware, similar to our BW object, even ABAP objects also follow the same convention. Unless and until you have customer namespace, you have to create either with Y or Z, the first character. And the next one is ABAP is case sensitive during comparison. So this means whenever you are doing comparison across a value stored in a variable, assume that you are checking Shyam Sundar lowercase with the uppercase, these are two different things. Okay. Whereas coding and all, if statement is statement, select statement, if you write in uppercase or lowercase, it doesn't matter. Only during comparison, the value stored in a variable, that time ABAP is case sensitive. Okay.
Yeah.
And every ABAP statement or expression must end with a period or full stop. Similar to C programming language, right? C or Java, there we will end with semicolon, right? Whereas in ABAP, we will end with full stop. And token within a statement should be separated by at least a single space. Like after every word, keyword, you should have at least a single space. Even more than one space is also allowed. Okay. It's like select single star or else concatenate a variable 1, variable 2, variable 3. At least a single space should be present. And coming to features of HABAP editor. So almost the same shortcut which we use in Notepad, Ctrl C for copy, V for paste, Ctrl X for cut, and S for save. And to toggle between display mode and change mode, you can use shortcut Ctrl plus F1. And to check the syntax of a particular object, you can use Control plus F2. And you can activate a program using Control plus F3. And comments, each and every programming language, right, it support comments. Comments are nothing but it will add the more meaning to your program, but it is it will be skipped during compilation. Okay, it is just like a additional information which you are feeding so that we can understand the program flow, right? So you can use shortcut Control plus left arrow or right arrow to toggle between commenting and uncommenting a particular piece of line. So this is about the features. So then I'll start with a simple program, gvalue_demo1. Click on create. Okay. In this screen, the title is mandatory and the type of the program is mandatory. Okay. These two are the mandatory. So title enter demo program one something. And type, you can see different types of programs. Okay. Executable programs, include program, model pool program, function groups, and different types which SAP support. As of now, we will concentrate on executable. As and when we proceed further, we will see the other which is relevant to us. Okay. So executable programs are the one which is which can be independently executed, okay, which does not depend on any other object. Whereas include program, we cannot execute independently. It has to be associated with other executable program. Okay. And status, actually these are like additional information. The mandatory is only these two fields. The status, right, if at all you are creating an object which is going to move to production, you can just add this. Okay, it is just like it doesn't impact any of the performance or your the functionality. Okay, it is just like additional information. Assume that you are creating a test program. If you choose as a test program, whenever you are doing a upgrade or maintenance activity, that is removal of unwanted object and all, if you see if they see test program, the business take a decision, delete all the program which is marked as a test program, you can do that. Or else sometimes what we will do, we will also see the description. Okay, if at all we wanted to delete the unwanted objects. Okay, and you can select a blank also. And authorization group, if at all a security people tell like maintain a authorization group, they will create a authorization group for you so that only the people who are authorized can execute this program. And application, okay, application is nothing but this particular program belongs to which area. You can choose business information bureau, if at all it is belongs to B2. Okay, this is just like a additional information. And there is something called editor lock over here, correct? If you choose this, nobody else other than this particular user can edit the program. So it is always recommended not to check this. Okay.
Okay.
And there is something called unit code checks. Since you are in SAP for a longer time, I guess you have worked in SAP 4.6E also, right? ECC?
Yes.
R3 4.6E, right? So that system or earlier BW system were not Unicode compatible. Okay, after ECC 6.0 onwards, the SAP start supporting Unicode. Okay, so there was a phase called UC check. It is mandated that we have to make each and every object as Unicode compatible. So we have to enable this. By default, it's enabled. If you remove this checkbox, it will throw an error. Unicode flag is not enabled. Please enable like that's it. Then click on save. And you can save in your respective package. I'm saving it in a local object. So as soon as you do that, it will take you to the next screen. The report, since it is an executable program, report followed by program name will come by default. And similar to any other programming language, to print a value to the user, you have used something called write keyword. In C and all, you will be using printf statement, right? Whereas in ABAP, we will use write keyword to print the values, right? We'll just say okay. And as I told you earlier, every statement has to end with full stop. If I remove full stop and check the syntax, it will throw an error saying like at line number 3 period is missing. Now the object is activated. You can execute and see the output. So as part of this example, what we are doing, we are printing the hard-coded value. Okay. So how can we declare a variable and print the value in a variable? So declare any kind of variables or internal tables, you have to use a keyword called data. Okay. Data L underscore, say suppose message type. To declare a variable which is of type string, I will use string. Okay.
Okay.
And after declaring a variable, I can initialize. LHS is equal to RHS, yes. Correct? So I can hard code this value. Since it's a character or string, it has to enclosed within single quotes. Okay. Now earlier example, I was printing the hard coded value. Now I am printing the value stored in a variable. So we can see the same output, but we are printing the value stored in a variable. Okay. This is how you will declare a simple string. Okay. Now,
yes.
Instead of string, in some cases, right, in your routines or wherever, right, by mistake in a hurry, right, since we have a lot of pressure with the deliverables and all, assume that we will write something like this, whether this code is valid.
I think so, because by default it will take as a character.
Correct. By default it will take as a character and whose length is 1, correct?
Yeah.
So if the, see, there is no syntax error or anything, but when we see the output, we can see only first character. So in this scenario, maybe we can go back and check the declaration, our declaration. Okay. And if you want to declare a character with the greater than 1 or length, you can specify within a small brackets. Okay. Type C. So this is about character, and unknowingly we are learning the, what I can say, classical reports in ABAP. Okay. When we, there are some reports in ABAP, means what is reporting in our BW, we'll use BigQuery to display the output. Whereas in normal ABAP, we'll write this kind of executable program wherein we'll pull the data from database table. We'll process the data, final data, either we'll use ALV reporting or else we'll print the content using write statement. Okay. And as part of next example, maybe we will see the concatenate operator, I can say. So save. So in most of our BW scenario, in source we have multiple fields, data will be there in separate fields. In target, you have to concatenate and have a single record, say first name and last name are separate field in the source, whereas in the target you have to make it a single field. Unless maybe you have company code, customer number, and followed by state code or region code, you wanted to create a unique key in the target which is combination of, or which is concatenated value of your country code, state code, country code hyphen state code hyphen your customer number. So how can we do that? Okay.
Yes.
So I can go with data L underscore F name type string, or else you can go with character also. Okay. L underscore L name. Type string. Similarly, L underscore full name. Type string. Okay. So now, either you can initialize the value. Instead of that, if you want to make this program dynamic, right, you can declare something called parameters. Okay. The parameter declaration is also exactly similar to data. But only thing is, instead of data, you will give parameter. If you give parameter, what will happen? It will create a screen for the user so that user can enter the value over there. Okay. P underscore F name type string. Or else you can use a predefined type like character 20 or 10. Okay. Similarly, P underscore L name type string. So to make this program dynamic, either I can use this only for our concatenate operation, or else I can assign the value coming from this and this variable to L name and F name,
yeah,
and I can use concatenate operation.
Yeah.
Yes. L underscore L name is equal to P underscore L name. So SAP is given a keyword called concatenate operator. Okay, what it will do? Concatenate. So you type a couple of initial character, it will suggest if there is any keyword with that. Okay, then once it suggest, you press tab, automatically it will come concatenate. Give the values or else variable names. L underscore F name, L underscore L name
into
yes. The target field L underscore full name. And if you want it to be separated by a space, let's print the value now. L underscore full name. Okay. If you execute this, we are getting Venugopal Nanjappa full name. It's concatenated, but I wanted it to be concatenated by space or concatenated by comma, separated by comma or space. How can I do that? SAP has given an additional syntax, say separated by at the end. Okay, this is the optional syntax. Okay, separated by, you can specify anything, the comma, full stop, space or anything. Got it?
Yes.
So this is one thing. And in most of our BW scenarios, right, if at all a particular these characters type or description kind of variable, right, name, description or some other fields, right, in BW sometime it won't accept the lowercase, correct? We have to convert that into uppercase, otherwise at DSO level during activation it will give an error, right?
Yeah.
So how can we convert a value to either uppercase or lowercase? So SAP has given something called translate statement, okay, translate keyword. Translate, give the variable name L underscore full name to uppercase or to lowercase.
Lower.
Specify anything.
Yeah.
So I'll specify lowercase. Let's activate this and see the output. It is converting into lowercase. If you want to convert this into uppercase, you can just use translate to uppercase. Understood?
Yeah.
And the next example would be the other way around. We have a field in the source info provider, which is in the format of first name comma middle name comma last name. So they wanted us to split into three different fields, or else we have a key in the format of say country, which will be first two character hyphen, then region, again two character hyphen, then the customer number. You wanted to split this entire key value at the hyphen. Anything before first hyphen has to be treated as country, of between first hyphen and second hyphen should be treated as region, and after second hyphen should be treated as country. How can we do that? Okay, so let me create a copy of this program. Third one, create a copy. So now change. Now we will be having only one parameter, which will be our full name. Okay.
Yeah.
And we will accept. We have full name, this thing and all. Okay. L underscore. Whatever the user entered, I am accepting to this variable. Now instead of concatenate, we have to use split keyword. Okay, split.
Yeah.
What you wanted to split? You wanted to split L underscore
full name into.
Sorry. Yes.
L underscore F name.
True, I believe. We have to give at first, okay? We have to
Okay.
Split L underscore full name at what is the separator? It can be comma, it can be full stop, or it can be any hash or anything, correct? So, split L for f name at comma, comma. And where you wanted to store? You wanted to store into L underscore.
L underscore.
F name. L underscore. L name. If you have only two, you can specify two. If you have middle name also, L underscore. M name. So now you can remove all this. You can declare one more variable called middle name.
M name. Yeah.
Yes. And now you can print the values.
L name.
Yeah. First name is equal to L underscore. F name.
Yeah.
Single. You can copy paste twice.
Middle name.
Middle name, and this will be the last
name.
Last name. Name. This will be the L name. Okay.
Yes.
So let me type as when I go for M. And okay, you see the output. Venugopal, yes. M and N. Anything before first comma, it is treated as first name. Between first and last comma, it is treated as middle name. Anything after second comma will be treated as last name. Assume that if we don't have any value in middle name, then there should be a comma. This is how our flat file also works, right? There is a field which is a blank, so we'll be having a blank with comma, correct? So now if you see, it is working as expected, correct? So that's how you can use split operator. The separator can be anything, okay? Based on requirement, you can specify the separator. Understood this part?
Yes.
Great. And just an additional information, if at all you wanted to give some meaningful information to this parameter, right? You can just go to edit, go to untext elements, okay? Click on text elements. So under selection text, you can see that variable value, variable name, okay?
Yeah, you can give some text for this.
Yes, full name. This you have to activate text also, otherwise it won't. Activate the text. Now we can execute your program. See, full name. It is giving us meaningful description. So this is about split and concatenate operator. And the next thing can be, there is one more important stuff which is called offset operators, okay? Have you heard about offset operator?
Yes, yeah.
Okay.
Because when we deal with this calendar month year,
correct,
we need to take the offset. Yeah.
So offset are nothing but offset operator is very much useful. If you are aware, just to discuss some date example, in SAP the date will be in the format of YYYY MMDD, correct? If at all you wanted to read a specific number of character out of a big string, so then we'll go with offset operator. So if you see, the year value will be first four character, month value will be next two character, and date value will be next two character. How can I read a first four character from a variable? So the syntax would be like variable name L underscore val plus, this is the variable, assume that this is the variable which will store a current system date or date field. So if you want to read a year value, you have to use this syntax, variable name plus
zero
start
four.
Position. Yes, zero of four. Zero indicate what is the starting position, and four indicate from that starting position how many number of character I have to consider. Okay.
Yeah.
Similarly, L underscore val, if you want to read the month, start from fourth character, read next two character.
Four of two.
Yes, four of two. Similarly, the next one would be the six of two. Correct?
Yes.
And also you can feed the value to the variable using the same flow. Okay. You can change the value of a particular position also. Got it?
Yes.
So that is about your offset operator and arithmetic and logical operators we have. Okay. Arithmetic operator. So in SAP I can say, for performing addition operation, similar to other programming language, we'll use plus, okay? And for subtraction, minus, for multiplication, star, and for division, we'll use forward slash. And for finding out the remainder after division operation, you'll use something called mod operator, okay? Are you aware of mod operator? Have you ever used?
I haven't used, but I am aware of.
Okay, okay, great. Then once we, these are the arithmetic operator, then we will move on to the logical operator. The logical operator, we can see a demo also, right?
And R.
Yes. The logical operators are like, which will perform logical operation. The final output would be either true or false. Okay. The output of that would be. So yes. We have something called equal to operator. You can check the equality using EQ or equal to symbol. Okay. This is for equality. Equality check. You can use not equal to check the two values are not equal. Either you can use NE or you can use continuous less than or greater than symbol. This is for not equality check. Okay. Then you have something called greater than GT. Okay. Or you can use greater than symbol to check the whether a particular value stored in a variable is greater than value stored in other variable. Okay. The next one is greater than or equal to. Okay. There are some scenario wherein you have to check both greater than and equal to values. So for that you have to use GE or greater than symbol followed by equal to. Got it? Similarly, we have less than or less than equal to, same thing actually, LT or LE, okay, less than LT or less than or equal to LE, understood?
Yes.
We will use less than symbol for the same, and less than greater than, those things, and you can use AND operator, OR operator, and NOT operator, okay, this will work similar to your logic gates. AND operator, if at all you will be using AND operator whenever you wanted to check, assume that you have a two condition, you wanted to make sure that your logic should execute only when both the conditions are true. In that scenario you have to go for AND operator. Okay, if both the conditions are true, then only the AND overall output will be true, otherwise it will be false. Okay.
Yeah.
Whereas OR operator you will use whenever you have a multiple condition or at least two condition. If one of these conditions satisfies, then you wanted to execute the logic. In that scenario, you will go for OR operator. Okay.
Mm.
NOT operator, if you at all you wanted, there is a expression, if you want to negate the output of that expression, assume that you are using, say suppose, you are checking two, whatever the logical expression is there, expression one is true and we are using AND operator and expression two is false. Okay. So overall output is false. If at all you wanted to make this as true, you can use NOT operator. Okay.
Yeah.
It will negate the output. That's it. And you can also see, you can use this particular operator predominantly in checking the content of internal table. If the internal table is initial, means we'll use the operator called each initial. Okay.
Each initial or not initial?
Yes. Each initial, it will be true when the content is blank. Correct. If we want to make sure that the logic will get executed only if the internal table has some record, then you can use each not initial. Okay.
Yeah.
So just to make sure that we have data to proceed further. These are your logical operator. We will be seeing as and when we will discuss. And the conditional operator like if else operator, okay, we have if else statement, say we have parameter p underscore num1 type I is used for declaring integer. Okay.
Yes.
P underscore num2 type I. So you wanted to check which one is the largest value. Okay.
Yeah.
So to check this kind of condition, you will go for if operator. If p underscore num1, either you can use greater than symbol or gt p underscore num2, then
right.
If condition satisfy, then only the control will come and execute the next line, right? Right?
Yes, yeah. P underscore
number one is
p underscore number.
Yes. So this is to check a single condition. If there is no alternative, yeah, logic to be executed. If you want an alternative logic to be executed, say suppose this example will print number one is largest only if number one is greater than number two, correct?
Yeah.
It will give some output. If I make number two is greater than number one, it is not giving anything. To handle this scenario, yes, you can go with else part, okay?
Else condition, yeah.
Yes. So we'll go with the if else condition when we have two alternatives based on a condition check.
Yes.
And as of now, we are seeing a simple example. In actual scenario, instead of printing the right statement, we'll apply some business logic based on our scenarios.
Yes.
Okay. So now you can see 30 and 500 or whatever, so you'll get the output. But if the both the numbers are same, it is saying number 2 is largest, which is wrong, right? If both the numbers are same or something, we need to put one more condition.
Yeah.
If there is something called else if, okay, you can add one more condition. Else if. You can write this condition in different fashion. Either you can retain the same p number 1 is less than, you can put lt, or else you can put p number 2 is greater than, both are one and the same, okay?
Yes, and one more condition.
Yes, we will put the default. If this condition satisfy, it will execute this. It will not, if it is not satisfy this condition, it will come to next available line. If it's this didn't satisfy, it will come to next available line. Okay.
Both are equal.
Yes, we can put both are equal. Okay.
Yeah.
2, 10, and 10. We can specify. We can see the values. Okay. And this is about our logical operator and if statement, else statement. And we have something called case statement, okay? If and else if statement, we will go when we have different alternatives, right? Means different possible values or different condition to be checked. Assume that since in BW, right, we have to think about the where and all we can enhance the performance, correct? So,
yeah.
So which may impact our load time to a greater extent. So what if else statement will do, right? It will check the condition line by line, okay? In sequential manner. First, it will check this condition. If it didn't satisfy, it will go to next condition. If it didn't satisfy, it will go to next condition. Like that, so on, okay? Just to give you a demo. Or something. So assume that we are checking a value stored in a variable, or else in our routine, we are checking a particular records company code. If the company code is US01, we will apply some logic. If the company code is US02, we will apply some different logic. Similarly, there can be 20 different possible company code or 10 different possible company code. Either we can go with if else statement or case statement, we'll see which one is better, okay? I will make this as character 4 because since it is a BW system, I don't have access to that table. Type C. Okay. I can follow something like this. If P underscore C COD equal to US01, apply some logic, right? All right. 1. Similarly, else, since I have not put full stop, it is not giving the suggestions. Okay. Else p underscore c code equal to US02 and apply some other logic. Similarly, I can have multiple statements now, right? Multiple possible company codes are present. Based on that, I am applying different logic, set of logic. So let's go with this menu only, and we will have one more else at the end, the default logic. Right. So now US1, US02, US03, US04, 5, 7. Right. Assume that in this case, how the program will work? If we have this logic in our routine or anything, if at all it is running inside a loop. So predominantly assume that out of 100 record, my 80% of record belongs to US05 or US06, okay? So what will happen? For every record, every time it will come and it's check this particular, check, yeah. This condition, it is false, this condition, this condition, this condition. After 4 condition check, in the 5th condition check, it is becoming true, correct? For every single record, if I have million of record, 5 time into the number of 5 into the number of time, means amount of time it will take to check this condition, number of records. It is, we are adding this much amount of extra time to our logic card. Entire processing time. So you can move this error. Okay, I'll make it as P_code. Yeah.
Define the.
Yes, I made it as P_code now. Okay. Now you can see in debugging mode also, it will keep checking from one by one. I assume that US06 I am entering. Okay.
Yeah.
It will go sequentially. Okay. It is checking this condition. It is false. It is checking this condition. False, false, false. Yeah. Now it is becoming true. Correct?
Yeah.
So after fifth check, it is going. So that's why means it is we are adding additional or means it won't impact that much. Maybe we can say a couple of minutes also at least, right? How can I overcome this particular issue? Is there any other syntax given by SAP? Yes, it has given something called case statement. Okay.
Case
statement. P8. You can create a copy of this program. 6. Okay, now you can just type case and you can press tab once again. Case, you can enter the variable name. Okay, and the case statement will support only integer and character. It won't support any other data type. Okay, like amount .00 or something, only integer or character type. Okay,
yeah.
If when P end of US01, we can apply the logic. When US02, we can apply different logic. US02. Similarly, irrespective of number of this thing, what you have, the condition, it won't execute the logic sequentially, okay? It will directly get into the matching condition, yes. 4, 5, 6. Okay. And if none of the things are matching, it will directly go to the default, that is when others. Okay.
Yeah.
So we can remove this. So assume that keep a breakpoint and execute and give US05. You can see, and also it is not necessary that it has to be in a sequence, it can be anywhere. Okay, so since I have opened more session, so to switch to new debugger, you can switch now. You can execute one by one. See, as soon as in a single comparison, it is directly going to the matching condition, correct?
Right. So
we are saving that much amount of extra time which we added in the logic. This is how you can enhance the performance. Okay.
Yeah.
So if you have only two condition check, if something is true, then apply some logic. If something is false, apply some other logic. In that scenario, you can always go with if else statement. Okay. If
there are, yes.
For a particular variable, if there are any different possible values, in that scenario only you can go for this case statement. And provided if your variable type is character or integer. Understood?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So then with this, we will stop the session at this point, and maybe we can continue in the next session. Okay. Is that fine? So just a bit here. So we have seen all these fundamental operators, but it is not like we are done with these all the stuff, because in each and every program each and every session we will be dealing with all these operators once again, right? So as and when the requirement, based on the requirement, if at all we need to learn new operators or new kind of syntaxes, we'll keep learning. Okay. And from the next session, we'll start with the internal tables and work area, and we'll see different possible scenarios and what are the best practices and how to declare local structure, global structure, how to declare internal, and different ways of you can create an internal table or work area, and what to use and what not to use. Those kind of stuff we'll see in the next session. Right?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
This is very important for BI. Yeah.
Sorry, okay. Go ahead, please. That's all with respect to today's session. Today we have seen introduction to SAP BI ABAP, and the steps which we are going to cover as part of this training. We also saw simple ABAP program, which involves the how to declare variables and different operator which SAP supports, like arithmetic operator, logical operator. We also saw condition statement, like if else statement and case statement, and which one is better in which kind of scenarios. In the next session, we will deal with internal tables and work area. Thank you so much and have a good one. Myself, Venugopal MN. I am a senior SAP BI ABAP consultant. If you are looking for online training on SAP ABAP, BI, BW ABAP and HANA, you can always reach out to me on my mail ID. That is venugopalmn1988@gmail.com. You can also call me on my mobile number. That is +91, which is India country code, followed by 973-998-3992. Thank you so much. Have a good one.